Hey, how you doing there again, folks? Me again, of course, Brandon Wenzel. Coming back at you, another offering off my sampler platter. Yes, hey, folks, sampler video series videos I've been doing for a while now. Go over there, try out food and drink items. I eat stuff, I drink stuff. And folks, I'm going to talk about the stuff. I'm going to let you know all that you need to know about hopefully delicious stuff that, at the time I'm doing this, folks, I'm not going to lie, it's a weirdly foggy day. Like, I genuinely, like, it is not, like, early in the morning. It's freaking noon at the time I'm doing this. I got outside for the first time today. I thought there was, like, a fucking fire or something. Like, I'm not entirely convinced that there isn't, but I haven't heard about anything, so I'm guessing it's just real foggy. Anyway, folks, it's a super simple format. I'm gonna go over there, I'm gonna try out food and or drink items. I'm gonna yammer on about it for a bit, and then, you know, you can just take that and do whatever you want with it. You can just use it as product information, for personal assurance, maybe, you know, some level of inspiration, you know, artistic or otherwise. You can write a song about it, you know. Take what you want from it. But anyway, I'm inside my truck. Whilst I'm inside my truck, I'm wearing a super cool shirt. Folks, when I wear super cool shirts, I like to highlight the super cool shirt. Super cool shirt am I wearing today? Boom, it's my Wargasm shirt. Which, if you are not familiar, Wargasm is a sort of electronic slash new metal slash yes duo from the UK. They are not the band from Massachusetts that was mainly active during the maybe late 80s to mid 90s or something like that. I forget exactly, but it's not them. I got to see these guys perform. They opened up for a band called Bloodywood. They really blew me away. Like, they did a fantastic job of opening the set, and I immediately afterwards, I got the shirt, I got a CD. Extremely awesome. I actually have three videos on this channel of their performance, just in case you're interested in giving them a check. They also have a bunch of really cool music videos and stuff, so. Anyway, what am I trying for y'all today, folks? Well, I gotta get to it quick because it's, boom, it's frozen. Can we get it? I don't know. Maybe. What is this, folks? This is the Burger King Frozen Kickin' Mango Fanta. Ha 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 ha. It's frozen, partially. It's partially melted, because it's warm. But, yeah, so this is a new offering from Burger King. I'm guessing it's, like, a limited-time item. And it's been a little bit since I've done anything from Burger King, so why the fuck not? Let's try it out, because, like I said, it's melting. Ooh. That's a big mango hit. I like it. I like this a lot, man. That's got some serious oomph to it. I'm genuinely kind of surprised because, like, I love frozen drinks. They're fantastic. It'd probably be the thing that ends up taking me out one day. Just too many frozen drinks. But the thing with frozen drinks is because it's frozen, like, you can lose a lot of flavor. You know, it's, you know, that kind of tempers things. They definitely accommodated for that. They definitely went over there and adjusted for that that lack of oomph that can come from being a frozen beverage. Because it's really, really punchy. And it's super good. Old people are looking at me funny because I'm in a parking lot right now. And they're like, what the fuck is that guy doing? Is he doing the drugs and the rock and roll music? Dial it back. Super flavorful, and the nice thing about it, I've reviewed mango things before on the channel, and I've mentioned, I like mango as a flavor, I think it can be used really well, but if you overdo it, for me, it really goes from being something that's just like a delicious tropical tasting treat, to something that's like really not anything I'm okay with. If you kind of go too punchy with it, it takes on like this, at least for me, almost like an earthy kind of taste, and not in a good way. And I've never been a big fan of something that's too punchy with the mango. Like a good example is like Pepsi Mango, which I don't hate, but they use, especially because it's like artificial mango flavor, it's too much, you know, and it overrides the overall experience for me. So I've never really gone back to that one. But with this, it's punchy, but they knew when to stop. Like, you get a lot of flavor, but it's kind of dialed down to a certain extent in terms of like the, you know, the mango-ness of the flavor. And honestly, it feels like maybe it's a bit of a blend. I would almost say maybe like a blend between like mango and then like maybe cherry as a base. That's what I'm going to guess. I'm not saying it's necessarily the case, but it, you get this initial hit of mango, and then once the mango kind of dials back, it begins to taste more like a cherry Fanta kind of thing, you know, or a cherry kind of beverage. So, and again, maybe that's just me. I mean, I love cherry, so maybe I'm just tasting cherry where there is none, but I gotta say, like, this is really good. I don't get frozen drinks very often from Burger King, and it's not because I don't want to, it's because usually I ask, and it's not available. But I will say, and I've mentioned this in previous reviews that I've done for Burger King stuff, the Burger King closest to where I live, for me historically, has had a terrible reputation as being one of the worst Burger Kings around. Like, it is miserable. But the last, like, 2-3 times that I've been there now, service was good. Everything came out the way it was supposed to. I didn't get a fuck up on my order or anything. You know, relatively speedy. You know, this time took a little bit longer, especially because I didn't get that big of an order. But okay, you know, it wasn't terrible or anything. It was, you know, within reason. So, I think that, I'm guessing he's the manager, but I think that he's really been kind of like more on about like trying to improve the reputation of the place. And every time I've been there, he's been there now. So, you know, sometimes, you know, especially with a franchise like that, you know, it's like, you know, you can't get good people. Sometimes you got to step up. You got to be that good person. I know that from working in fucking retail. You know, I worked 7 years at a gas station. And let me tell you, folks, like, I had 7 managers in 7 years. Okay, and I had really great managers, and I had really shitty managers, and then I had some that really didn't leave that much of an impact. One of the biggest differences between a good manager and a bad manager is that a good manager understands that part of their role is that they are still part of the team. If they're always up here and you're always down there, they're shit. I don't fucking, they're garbage. There can be a separation, for sure, but you still have to be part of the team. And I had managers, man, who it's like, you bring something to their attention, and it was effectively just, it's not my fucking job. And it's like, no, actually it is. You're the fucking manager. You're supposed to be there. Fucking talking about you, Daphne. She'll never fucking see this, but even if she does, fuck her, man. She was a terrible manager. And I try not to be that person, but I had to deal with her ass for like 2.5 years. Anyway, 2 questions have to be asked. Would I get this again? Would I go over there and recommend it? The drink, not working under Daphne for 2.5 years. That I would not recommend. The answer is yes and yes. Seriously, it's really good. I like that. I like the way the mango flavor hits, where it's punchy, but not too mango-y. I like that they, you know, kind of kept it grounded while still being very flavorful. And it's just, you know, it's a tasty frozen treat. I like it. And as for recommending it, I mean, if you don't like mango stuff, honestly, I think you could still probably get away with it, because again, I feel like it's a blend of something, so, you know, you might be able to kind of go, be able to get away with it anyway. But yeah, man, it's just tasty, and as long as you got a good Burger King and their stuff is working, I'd recommend it. Anyway, 5 things before I get out of here. Have yourself a great rest of day. Spectacular rest of week. Monumental response to Ben's rest of your folks. You can go over there and have yourselves a truly frozen fantastic rest of your life. Because I like the frozen Fanta. I just need it to be available when I go to the Burger King. Final 2 things. Number 1, try to bring some positivity in the world. It's not always possible. It is, however, always appreciated. But what you do, can't do all the time. I know I can't do all the time. Here's what you're going to do, folks. You're going to try not to be an asshole. Now, folks, it's not always the easiest thing in the world to not be an asshole. You know, like I said, I went over there and threw a little shade at my former manager, Daphne, who, you know, and to be, hey, I haven't seen or dealt with her in over 7 years at the time I'm doing this. It's been that long since I've been divorced from doing my shitty gas station job. And I will say this. I did not find that she was a particularly good manager at the time. I do not wish her ill. You know, and my hope would be that in whatever job or position that she's in these days, that, you know, maybe she's stepped up a little bit. Or at least found something that works better for her than, you know, doing what she was doing. That is a PT Cruiser. Well, I haven't seen one of those in a little bit. You know, and it is important. Trust me, and I say this, you know, from personal experience, when you do have those issues and those hang-ups, it is important to go over there. Take a step back. Try to mitigate the level of assholeness in your lives, because at the end of the day, folks, you know, we're all moving forward, you know, and the best way to do that as much as possible is to go over there and leave that baggage behind. And even though sometimes it might creep up a little bit when you think about it, you know, just leave it to the side. That's the best way to keep moving. Very final thing, folks, do the thing. Whatever the thing is for you, that's what I want you to go out and do. Folks, maybe you're going to go over there. Maybe you're going to try yourself out some frozen Fanta mango what the hell ever that I just tried. And maybe your Burger King is going to have it all, it's going to be available all the time. Maybe they've got like a really good crew and it's fantastic. And maybe it'll just so happen, turn out that maybe the person who's running that particular franchise that you're, you know, that you're at is my former manager, Daphne. And maybe she's actually got her shit together and, you know, is doing a banging job of leading her crew and making that the best damn Burger King that she possibly. And I don't even mean that in a derogatory way. Like, oh, she's managing a Burger King. Fuck that, man. You're still the manager. You're still doing a fucking important job. So, to Daphne and to all the other shitty managers I've had over the years, you know, no hard feelings. Some hard feelings. Bye!